how to start a plumbing business. That's what we're going to talk about in this video, and we're going to talk about it right now.
I'm Roger Wakefield, Lead AP, the Expert Plumber. I've been plumbing over 38 years, and I have every master endorsement in the state of Texas. On this channel, I'm teaching you how to fix your plumbing fast and free. If you haven't been here before, please subscribe so you don't miss anything.
How to start a plumbing business. We all have that entrepreneurial seizure. If you've ever read Michael Gerber, you understand that you walk out of a plumbing company thinking, I know what I need to do to open a plumbing company, to start a plumbing business. We all know that we're good plumbers, and we think the people we're working for are just making a fortune off us. And it's so funny because on social media, I see this all the time. People think that the companies are just getting rich off their sweat. And don't get me wrong, that's where they make their money. But every company out there isn't getting rich, guys. I've got years of experience, but I had to learn what I didn't know. So the first thing that I'm gonna tell you is make sure you've got the right licensing, okay? You need to make sure that you're licensed, you've got everything set, you've got the right licenses in your city or state, whatever's required, and make sure you know. If cities require certain licensing, you may have to have a different license or different registration in each city. So that takes me to number two, make sure you're registered. In the areas that we're in, we have to register in each different city or municipality that we work in. And if you're not registered, your plumbers can get in trouble for working there. So you want to make sure that you do it right. That's going to be your biggest deal. Also on the registration, make sure you've got your name registered with the Attorney General. The reason being, you don't want to build a company with your name and then somebody else come in and say, hey, I like that name. They build a company, start advertising it, they get the name and start getting your phone calls. Make sure that you register your name. That way that is yours. No one else can use it. And also, if you have a unique trademark, make sure you get that registered too. That way nobody tries using that. Number three, one thing you really want to do is talk to an attorney. Make sure you set everything up properly. This is really a big deal because most plumbers walk out and we're like, look, I just want to start making money. And I understand that, but you've got to cover yourself. So talk to an attorney, make sure that you've got a good business plan. Make sure that you understand what you're going to do, when you're going to do it, and how you're going to do it. And I know talking to an attorney is not always the funnest thing for a plumber to do, but sometimes they may be able to help you make decisions and make the best decision that's going to help you in the long run so you don't end up having problems later. Number four, and this is another big one, talk to a CPA. The reason being is you need to know what to do with your money. And I know plumbers think, look, I'm just going to make lots of money and I'm going to get it out there. But if you want to know how to start a plumbing company the right way, make sure you talk to the right people. Guys, again, a CPA can help set things up to where when you bring money in, it goes to the right places. Believe it or not, all that money is not yours. So the two things that a CPA can really help you with is setting up a budget, meaning you're going to need tools, but you can't afford to buy those tools with the very first check you get from somebody. You may need to invest that into other things. And knowing how to set up a budget and how to set it up properly is a great thing. But following it is the key to success. If you learn how to work by your budget, then you don't have any unforeseen circumstances pop up that give you problems later. And when I said all that money isn't yours, trust me, Uncle Sam wants his too. You're gonna have state taxes and you're gonna have federal taxes, and you need to make sure you've got everything set up and you're putting it away the right way. One person that I know, Chaz Wilson, wrote the 5+1 book, has actually done, he's got his account set up where he knows what percentage of every dollar coming in goes into what account. Really a neat process, because then if one account gets low, he knows where he's losing money. I love this idea. I'm just not quite that disciplined yet, but I want to strive to set up that way to where I know what my percentages are, which I do, but I want to get my account set up where every dollar that comes in goes into a certain account. And then when there's a low account, it's like, okay, wait a minute, what's wrong here? It's a great way to show you how to know where your problems are. Number five is insurance, CYA. Insurance, you need three different kinds. You need your company insurance. You need to make sure that your business is protected. Trust me, there are people out there that want your money. They're going to try to sue you. They're going to try to, another word that rhymes with it, shaft you. And then they're going to try to get all your money that they can get. Make sure you are insured and covered. Here in Texas, I go well above what's required by the state because I want to make sure I'm covered. And think about that. The minimum liability insurance here in Texas, if you hit somebody with a Mercedes, you don't even have enough money to cover that. Make sure your insurance policy is enough to cover it. And believe it or not, guys, it doesn't cost that much more for more insurance. Make sure you protect yourself. So that's your business and your vehicle. You've got to have them insured too. Make sure, because you don't want your guys to be in a bad situation because they had an accident and the vehicle's not insured. And it's either your fault or their fault or both of you, but now everybody's getting sued and you all take chances on losing everything. The other insurance, workman's comp. You've got to make sure your guys are covered. Guys, we don't ever want it to happen, but guys do get hurt on the job sometime. My wife actually hurt her back yesterday sneezing. She has a hard time moving around today. So make sure that you cover yourself. And guys, I've done this for years. You pick up heavy toolboxes, water heaters, you crawl around in our house, you get in a bad position, things can happen. Get workman's comp, that way your employees don't end up owning your company. Now for the big spender, number six, marketing. The biggest problem plumbers have, the biggest thing that we have to think about all the time is how do I make the phone ring? Marketing is the big deal. Now, when I say the biggest dollar value, because when I first started out, I was using pay-per-click. I was sending money to Google. And you know what? When you first start out to make your phone ring, that may be what you have to do. But guys, be prepared. Here where I'm at, I was paying up to $150 a click. Guys, that's just for somebody to click on the ad. That's not calling me. That's not booking a job. That's not using me. That is just them clicking on my ad and that taking them to my webpage. So your webpage is also part of your marketing. Make sure that you've got something set up where people can find you and see you. One trick I learned from one of the best marketing guys I work with, make sure your webpage looks like the biggest guys in town. Because when people click on your page, they don't know if you're the biggest or the smallest. So when you first start out, like I said, you don't have much money, so pay-per-click may be tough. So here's what I recommend, learn how to network. Now, I've talked about this in some other videos, and if you actually already get out and network to grow your company, do me a favor, leave a comment down below and let me know who you network with. What group is it? Does it meet weekly? Does it meet monthly? Or is it just a group that shows up every now and then and hangs out and passes out cards? Because there are right ways to network, and we actually talk about that in some other videos. That's how I started growing my business, learning the right way to network. The other thing is social media. I talk about networking all the time. LinkedIn is actually networking online. Those of y'all that don't know, I've actually spoken on that at different video marketing conferences. Guys, teaching LinkedIn and networking is huge because that teaches people like us how to grow our business without spending a lot of money. So you do that, then you learn to use the other social media platforms. Look at me, I'm using YouTube. Get your word out there. Get your information out there and learn to talk to your customers. Facebook is another great one. Make videos to let your customers know what it is that you do. What service is it that you provide? Don't try to sell them though. Don't say, hey, look, I can come do your water heater today, or I have guys sitting around here at the shop doing nothing because our phones aren't ringing. Make informative videos. Teach people how to do things that they can do. Guys, if you teach them that, they will end up calling you to do the things they can't do. I mentioned networking and LinkedIn and all that all the time. Actually, down below in the description, there is a link. We put together a PDF to teach guys like you and I the exact things we need to know to network. Click on that link. We'll send you the PDF. It is great because it will tell you what you need to get started to get out and network. And that's a great way to grow your business. Other social media platforms you may want to get on, you know, check them out. Here's the deal, guys. Find out where your customers are and get your voice, your face, your word, your logo out in front of them. The last one I'm going to mention, which is really the first one I mentioned, is pay-per-click. Guys, you can spend a lot of money on pay-per-click. I recommend learning how to network, use social media, and use video. make videos, get in front of your customers, let them see what you do, because pay-per-click is expensive. Don't get me wrong, if you're hooked up with the right people, it can work right, but I would rather spend that money on my website or social media, build my SEO right, that way my website is bringing people in forever. Number seven, and this is the big one, because if you ever sell your company, this is what people are gonna wanna buy, your CRM, your customer relationship management. Every time we get a customer, we get their email address, we enter them in the system. Guys, you can take that email address and you can actually communicate with your customers all year long. Don't spam them, don't try to sell them, don't just tell them about the latest coupon that you've got out there. Send them information, remind them at the beginning of wintertime, hey, you might wanna cover your hydrants, your frost proofs, anything like that. And yes, we even cover frost proofs here because it does get cold enough, we've seen them break. Make sure that your people understand what it is that you can teach them. In the beginning of spring, send them a deal, hey, have you flushed your water heater? This is a great time to do it. It's starting to get warm outside. Run a hose out there, flush your water heater. Do what you can do for PM, preventive maintenance. Get that in front of your customers. Guys, if you will bring value and good content to your customers every time you send them something, you are always gonna stay top of mind. So if you have opened a plumbing company lately or you're thinking about one, leave me a comment down below and let me know what of these things you're gonna do or what of them you're already doing. If there's things here you're doing that work, please let us know. And if there's things I didn't mention here that other people can learn from, please leave a comment and let us know. I'm Roger Wakefield, Lead AP, the Expert Plumber, and I'll see you on the next video if you don't get flushed.